In this second video in this series on state-space systems, we will see how to use state-space systems for control design. We'll continue from where we left off, and for the state-space plant model we developed, we observed from the step response plot that the plant takes a little over a second to rise to the step reference change and takes over 2 seconds to settle. So let us design a controller which eliminates steady state error and reduces motor settling time to under 0.5 seconds. In order to develop this controller, we must check that the plant is controllable, and we can use the CTRB command to do that. This command computes the controllability matrix, and we can check the rank of this matrix using the rank command. The rank command returns a full state rank, indicating a controllable plant. Now that we know that the plant is controllable, let's design a full state feedback controller where all of our three states are measured. The C matrix of the plant therefore must be modified to a 3x3 identity matrix, and we can do this using the I command. Now that our plant has been set up for full state feedback control, let us design our controller by placing the dominant closed loop poles using the place command. The place command accepts the state space matrices A and B along with the desired pole locations as inputs and returns the corresponding controller gains for the state feedback controller. The A and B matrices have been extracted from the state space object, similar to how you would extract fields of a structure in MATLAB. To approximate this system to second order, I place the third pole at minus 21 in order to minimize its contribution to system dynamics. Now that we have designed our controller, let us define our closed loop state space model using the feedback command. This command by default assumes negative feedback if we just pass the plant and the controller gain K as inputs. However, an optional third argument with a value of plus 1 or minus 1 can be used to explicitly specify positive or negative feedback. We can verify the location of our closed loop poles using the pole function. This location should match our desired pole locations. Now that we have defined our closed loop model, let us analyze the motor speed response for a step reference input using the step command. I extracted the motor speed output from the closed loop state space object, similar to indexing into a 1D array in MATLAB. Looking at the transient response of our closed loop system, we observe that we have now met our settling time requirement, but the steady state error is large and the motor does not track the reference input very well. Please note that in full state feedback control, all the states X are measured and multiplied by the controller gain K, and this result K times X is then subtracted from the reference. So we should really not expect K times X to equal the desired output. We can fix this issue by using the concept of reference scaling, where the reference signal can be scaled to make it equal to the steady state value of K times X. In other words, we can scale the closed loop by a factor equal to 1 over our current steady state value, which can be computed using the DC gain command. Now that we have scaled the reference signal, when we compute the motor speed step response for the modified closed loop system using the step command, we observe that in addition to meeting our settling time requirement, we have eliminated steady state error. We can also use the Linear System Analyzer app in Control System Toolbox that lets us analyze system response in both time and frequency domain. We start by first importing the state space objects of interest from the MATLAB workspace. Then we select the plot configuration or the layout of the plots that we wish to display. Let us plot the motor speed step response for the open loop plant and the closed loop system in the top figure, and the closed loop Bode plot for the motor speed in the lower figure. We can use the IO selector to visualize just the motor speed in the time and frequency domain. Linear System Analyzer displays the IO selector for MIMO systems when you right-click on the selected plot. Finally, we select the time or frequency domain characteristics that are of interest to us. For example, in the time domain, we might be interested in settling time. So we can highlight this value on the step response plot for both the open and the closed loop. In the frequency domain, we know that the steady state system response can be analyzed by looking at the DC gain of the Bode plot. From our Bode plot, we observe that the closed loop system has zero DC gain, since our closed loop system has zero steady state error, and this is also evident from the closed loop step response plot. Instead of steady state error and settling time requirement in the time domain, we could also have a bandwidth requirement for our closed loop system in the frequency domain. The larger the closed loop system bandwidth is, the faster our closed loop system response will be. The 3 decibel bandwidth for our closed loop system is about 7 radians per second. So now we have designed a full state feedback controller and analyzed performance of closed loop system in time and frequency domain. This shows how we can use state space systems for control design, and this concludes the video.